Been a while since I've made a post, so I figured I got a little bored here on Sunday afternoon, decided I'd post up some video. This is my CTC-12 RCA. This set is I've got a long time ago. It was missing a flyback. Somebody apparently took it to a shop and they pulled the flyback and didn't put one back in. Anyway. The deal on this set was it was pretty much all original. I mean, I didn't touch anything besides putting a flyback in. And I decided that I would go ahead and replace some caps in the grid circuit of the matrix amplifiers. I did that, and it seems to help a little bit as far as keeping the... Well, it's hard to tell here, but, well... It's a sort of what I believe to be a DC restoration issue. Those particular capacitors, the way I understand their work, are partially charged up by a pulse from the blanker tube, a negative pulse from the blanker tube, and that maintains a certain bias in the grid circuit of that tube that pretty much clamps the DC level of that particular output from those matrix amps. I mean, that's the way I understand what I've read on it. You know, I don't know. Running some vintage programming here. I think the contrast is a little soft. I don't know if it's the programming or if it's the tubes or what have you, but it's not that bad. Of course, some of these old programs seem to have lost a lot of their saturation. Like, you'll see a commercial come on, it'll blow it out. But anyway. This is what I wanted to see. You'll notice how the darkness of the background changes when the text comes on. Or you can really see it there. I was hoping the capacitor change would help with that, and I think it actually has. But I mean, look, these kids almost disappear. So I'm still trying to work that out and figure out what's going on. I'd hope the capacitor change would have made that better. Yeah, I think it may have, but not 100% right. Oh, the other issue on this set, oh boy, this is like one of the worst shows ever. Anyway, the other issue I had on this set was never heard of her. Oh God, Ron Papillo used to be on Welcome Back, Cotter. Don't know this guy. Abe Vigoda, Fish. Yep, Nancy Walker, Rhoda's mom. Anyway, the linearity isn't off, it's just the way I'm holding the camera, I think. But, back to the original problem, the volume. For a while there, the volume would have like a dead spot. Listen how linear it is now, as I slowly turn up. Okay, before, it had a dead spot, it would come up, get soft right here, and then come up some more. And that turned out to be a shorted... Oh, I hate the way I think it's so dark. Bright, dark, bright, dark. It turned out to be a short on one of... Here, I'll come over here and look at the schematic. I'll show you what was going on. Let me get my pointer. So right here, we have the volume control. And... here's the pot, and there's these two taps on the pot. Why can't I get close enough to see that? Why won't it focus? Well, one of these taps, gosh darn it, was shorted to the ground. It actually is this one right here. I'm sorry, here's the volume pot. This goes to a 47K. That's a tap on the pot, 47K to ground. Well, this was grounded. This little tap, this little piece of the pot that came out the back of the pot was grounded, so that's what's causing the oddness in the volume. So it just like the tab got pressed down, and that was that. Now, so fix the volume, it works properly now, and I'll show you the last thing I did on the capacitors. These are those grid coupling caps. This focusing is going to drive me nuts. I've got a cap installed right now, this right here, you can't see it. Came out, and as you can see, the eye will not open all the way up, so I replaced that, and that's it. I'm going to try to change this focus up.